Hey, it's SGU, and welcome back to the Colt Cannon Road to the Show series here in MLB The Show 17 on the PS4. You see Cannon talking with teammates here in the clubhouse, Triple A New Orleans with the baby cakes in the Miami Marlins organization. So it's time to get back to some baseball here. We're at the halfway point of the Triple A season, and it's time to get going.
Down, but not totally out at the midpoint. This team is challenged by its skipper to make a push before it's too late.
Yeah, the record is pretty pitiful at this point, so he's pleading for us to turn things around. We get a two-time bonus for the multiplier for experience points for a game because of the pep talk, and we'll see if that works for us against the Oklahoma City Dodgers, who, by the way, are playing much better baseball, 56-34, 22 games above 500. Nice season for them. Colt Cannon still hitting over 400 at this point in AAA. I'm sure that'll probably cool off a little bit, but a hot start. And he's going to find a hot start to this game as he gets that one past the shortstop and out into left field for a base hit. Gets himself on for his teammates here. Going to see a replay and see how he sneaks this between third and short and under the stretched glove of the shortstop there for a single. So it's 2-1 Dodgers at this point. Runner on first, and this ball is put into play down the left field line, but very shallow, and caught for an out. So Colt Cannon now 1-for-2 to start this ball game. Let's take it on to the next at bat. Still 2-1 score, and again he's going to put the ball in play to left field, but this time hit much deeper, and it's off that scoreboard. Apparently that's in play, because that's going to be a double for him. Hit that anywhere else to the left or the right of the scoreboard, and I guess it's a home run, but a little unfortunate event here for him as that stays in play. Watch this, right off the Riverboat Field logo there above the scoreboard. Just one of the quirks of the ballpark, I guess, that remains in play. So here is a ball to center field, and you see having to kind of retreat on that and backpedal to make the catch. So he will go ahead and take third base, does Colt Cannon. That's alert base running to know that he's not going to have a chance to throw him out. And so with two outs, that pitch gets away from the catcher. It's ball four, but Colt Cannon's able to score on the pass ball, wild pitch, whatever it's going to be ruled. So that's what moving up 90 feet on a sac fly or taking the extra base will do for you. You get to have a chance to score on a ball like that. So out to first base. And he's going to snag this one down the first baseline, get up and step on that bag with plenty of time. It's a nifty play right there by Colt Cannon with the glove. Remember now, first base not his original position. He was an outfielder, asked to be moved to first base by his Double-A manager at the time because they thought it would fast track him much more so up to the Marlins. So we got a 2-2 game and we got extra baseball. 10th inning, and that one smoked to center field, but it's going to stay up and be caught. So no reward for hitting the ball hard this time. You see the center fielder running that down and making the catch. So are we going to play some more baseball? Yes, we are. Let's go to the bottom of the 11th. Slow grounder to first base. Just step on it. Easy routine play. And we play on. Got another at bat for Colt Cannon. What inning are we in now? Let's check it out as he steps in. And well, I'm not sure yet because graphic's not there. They're going to intentionally walk him, so he's not going to get a chance to hit in whatever inning this is, 12th, 13th, I don't know. He takes his base. Will it work out for the Dodgers strategically? Well, yeah, we're still 2-2, and we're into the bottom of the 14th. Another ground ball to Colt, who will step on the bag. Very routine once again. Let's go to the top of the 15th. Still 2-2. Oh, he gets robbed by his first base counterpart. Makes a nice play right there, steps on the bag, and gets the out. So Colt Cannon retired, and the Dodgers looking to maybe walk this off as we see the play-by-play, and that's exactly what they do. They get the hit that ends this game in 15 innings, kind of like the Red Sox and Blue Jays last night, except that one ended on a Hanley Ramirez bomb over the Green Monster. So a single, a double, and an intentional walk. Not too bad of a day right there for Colt Cannon. So we go forward a few games. He hits a home run while simming. Of course he does. He's at four now. And gathers a couple RBI. So we go to the last game of the series with Oklahoma City. Hitting the field once again. Let's see if we can take a victory before we leave town. So, yeah, like I said, dropping under 400, but that was not really a surprise. We're at 372 for the average right now. Kind of figured things would average out, if you will, and that would drop a little bit. And we're wearing another number again today. No, he's not wearing his customary number 11. Now it's 23. I really don't understand the game's logic on how it keeps switching numbers. Did somebody come to town that demanded his number? I mean, I just really don't understand. It seemed like somebody had 11. Somebody did have 11 as he came. Remember, it was the pitcher, because there were two number 11s on the field at one time. Now they make him switch. That's a nifty play, by the way, as he fields that one to the second base side, diving, gets up and throws to the pitcher. And they complete that nice out. But why 23? I mean, 23, that number's fine. It looks good on them, but I just don't understand why the flip-flopping constantly of the numbers for players in Road to the Show. It's happened to Jake Homerman a lot, and it's happening here to Colt Cannon. So he pops up there. We got a 2-2 game once again. That's very familiar to the last ball game we highlighted. Here he has a 10-pitch at bat and draws a walk. That is very nice right there. Patience, following things off, and then getting on base one way or another. This ball is hit down the left field line, but that's going to be caught. Inning is over, so Colt will not score a run, but he got himself on base. The Dodgers win the game, and we will move out of here on to another series. But first of all, the Dodgers get to celebrate, including their outfielders, dabbing a little bit on the way towards the clubhouse. So no hits in this game, just a walk. We did manage a series split, so we'll take that. It's improving on what we've done in the first half of the season. So we're going to be taking on the Round Rock Express next up. And this will be yet another road series for us. 40-55. Man, we are 15 games below 500. I know, it's just minor league baseball. Not too caught up on what the standings are and stuff. We're caught up on working ourselves up to the major leagues. That is first and foremost. And we're wearing 23 again and getting a single up the middle to start our day. Colt Cannon, no matter what number you put on his back, wants to show up and produce, and that's what he's doing in this at-bat with the single to center field. So now on first base, you got a 3-1 count and one out. Now, we don't look to steal a lot. We got kind of reprimanded by the manager for taken too many liberties in a past episode, but he is going to take off here. And no, he's not running in quicksand. It only looks like it, but he does steal the base. He gets just enough a jump, and the throw is a little bit high from the catcher, allowing Colt Cannon to steal with the head first slide. So, okay, we'll take it. Shouldn't get yelled at by the manager this time because we were successful, and we're not going to do it excessively. That's fair down the third base line and down into the left field corner. Colt Cannon will score easily. So stealing that base paid off because it put him in scoring position, and that's exactly what he did, scoring a run on that hit. Let's go now to further action. Top of the third inning, 2-0 New Orleans. The Baby Cakes with the lead. This ball put in the air, but it's going to be caught by the center fielder out in right center, and Colt Cannon is retired in this at-bat. Let's move to further play in this ball game. Another at-bat. This is top of the fifth now, still 2-0, and oh, we saw a base hit like that early on in the episode, but this time shortstop makes a play and throws him out. So we'll stay at that very 2-0 score. We got a nice pitching performance so far by our team, although a couple runs on the board. That one is going to be hammered to the opposite field gap. I'll have to chase this down, and he's going to have at least a double. Yeah, he'll pump the brakes right there and stay. As we know, the speed is not really there yet for Colt Cannon. Don't know if it ever will be, to be honest. We'll bump it up, obviously. It'll get better because you have the means to do that with experience points. But, you know, he's not a burner by any means. But there is a nice opposite field double. Finds himself on third now with two outs. That's going to be dribbled back to the pitcher. He makes a play despite us diving for home plate there. It's not going to matter. That's out number three. But we do have a 6-2 lead. So that's good news. You got a 1-2 count. That ball bounces and gets away from the catcher. That's going to allow the runner to move up into scoring position now as Colt has a chance for an RBI. Catcher just couldn't quite corral that one. So here we go. It'll all be insurance at this point. If we get anything, oh, he gets it to right field. And I thought maybe that had a little more carry off the bat. but it's going to be caught out in right field. Runner will tag up and go to third base, and he will get there. So it's a productive out, moving a runner over, but it's not going to be a hit for him. So can we finish this off? Later innings here, down the line. That has nothing to do with Colt Cannon, but it is a catch by our right fielder. So just kind of holding things down here until hopefully we can secure a victory. You see the right fielder chasing this one down, and he is able to do just that. We get a win today, which is always nice when you're 15 below 500. To pull out a victory, we've got it. We get to celebrate tonight, and hopefully continued success. So two hits for Colt Cannon in this game, a single and a double. He scored a run as well. So we actually have a successful start to the series, winning the first three, and we actually sweep that series. How about that? Okay, so Nashville, the Nashville Sounds are next up. You see the career stats coming in at AA and AAA. Very abbreviated here, as it's just this half a season or so he's played in professional baseball. So that average continuing to come down, still respectable, 329, but it's not 400, obviously. Oh, he gets tied in knots right there for a strikeout. Not his best at bat. He'll try to recover from that and do better the next time around. They're down 2-0, and we got another chance for a fielding play where it's, can he handle this hop? Yeah, he gets it from his knees, throwing to the pitcher who wins the race to the bag. Nice defense all around once again by the Baby Cakes, and it started out by Colt Cannon, making the stab at first base. Pitcher does a nice job covering the bag. We got a 3-0 deficit, though, and how about that? That's going to be down for a hit, going opposite field. Rather sharp single. Finds himself on again. But can they score some runs in this game? They haven't done it yet. Well, they get one, but they're down 5-1. This one, he goes up and gets and hits it hard, but right at the right fielder. What are you going to do? Hit line drives, and you'll get on base more often than not, but this time is not one of those times. The Baby Cakes are on their way to dropping this game. So after sweeping Round Rock, having a little more trouble with Nashville. So that's where we're going to leave off for this episode. Didn't get any home runs in this one, except for Simming. Oh, wow, he's got six of them now after Simming. But yeah, apparently we can't hit him. Maybe we can actually hit a home run next time. We'll see you next time for more Colt Cannon.